It's telling how regularly it happens that most prominent politician taking on Donald Trump is not some fiery Democratic upstart, but Hillary Clinton, the Democrat he already beat. 9 months into Trump's administration, it's as if the campaign never ended. And Clinton, though she's typically the only one accused of overstaying her political welcome, is but one character in the Democratic Party's extended walk down memory lane. This week, Barack Obama, who had until recently stayed out of the national spotlight, put his charisma to work for the Democratic National Committee, his first fundraiser for the party since leaving office. Joe Biden unveiled his new daily podcast, and Bernie Sanders positioned himself front and center in the country's big healthcare debate. Meet the new Democratic stars, same as the old ones. It isn't what the resistance envisioned, but the party appears to be stuck with familiar faces thanks to never building a Democratic bench and putting all their hopes into a 2016 basket that fell spectacularly apart. At a time when the party might be drafting a blueprint for the future, it's rehashing debates of the past election. Could Sanders really have won? Did Clinton lose because sexism? And what exactly was Russia's involvement anyway? It's important to learn from the past, and crucial to revisit, even investigate, these questions. Yet more than seeking out broader truths or extracting overarching lessons, Americans seem fixated on clinging to their candidates and nostalgia. And while Clinton's attracted the lion's share of public attention with her book turned full swing, she's far from the only offender. Between governing duties and trying to win re-election in Virginia, Tim Kaine might be considered to have a rather full plate, but that hasn't stopped him from opining in print on Democrats' economic message, knocking Trump in state stump speeches, and reminding local audiences that, yes, he and Clinton really did win the popular vote. Meanwhile, Obama, though he typically won't deign to name the president by name, is out decrying Trump's moves on everything from immigration policy to his response to Charlottesville and a lack of aid to Puerto Rico. At major fundraisers this week, Obama expounded on the state of the world and nature of leadership, and just as significantly, his efforts were well met. Amid the all the divisiveness, an attendee of one fundraiser said, "It renewed my hope. The good news and the bad news for Democrats is that the campaign of hope and change already happened.